So thanks for having me.
So we've known for a long time, doctor, that diabetics are much more likely to suffer from severe cases of COVID. What can you tell us about this other possible connection to diabetes and COVID?
We've seen an increased number of studies coming out over the last couple of months showing an association between people that have had COVID and subsequently developed diabetes. This is both type 1 and type 2 diabetes, mostly type 2 diabetes in adults. But we do see an increasing number, including a study that came out in Lancet a week ago that shows a pretty strong correlation, about a 40% increased risk of diabetes in the year following COVID-19 diagnosis for people that have recovered.
Wow.
So that's somewhat new information. And I would say just clinically, we've seen cases of people developing new diagnosis of diabetes in that setting, but hadn't really put two and two together completely. So this is helpful clinical information as well.
Well, how concerned should people really be? Many people, of course, as you know, have been exposed to COVID through the Delta surges, the Omicron surge. What do folks need to know about their potential risk here?
One important thing to point out here with all of these studies is that they really stopped looking at patients in early 2021 for the most part. And so these are mostly COVID diagnoses from 2020 with a year of follow-up and then subsequent time to analyze the data. And so we really don't know what vaccination has done to this correlation, if anything. And I would say we're seeing from these studies that the sicker patients were more likely to develop diabetes in general. I think the jury's still out on what Omicron will hold. Will it be a 40%, 30% increase or something less than that in the setting of vaccines? I think it's possible.
Well, kids we know have a lower risk for severe COVID symptoms. So what can you tell us about their risk for long-term complications like diabetes?
So in general, kids fortunately have less of a risk of long COVID symptoms. That's also true for diabetes. There is an association that the CDC has described and that several studies have shown as well between kids developing type 1 diabetes predominantly and after a COVID diagnosis. So there is an association there, but in general, most long COVID symptoms are less in kids who are vaccinated. And again, most of this data comes from the pre-vaccination era, so we really don't know what vaccinations will do to these kind of associations or numbers.
Got it. Okay, but so for our viewers who maybe are just hearing about this and they're concerned, what are some early symptoms to watch out for?
So for diabetes, if you're undiagnosed, you might start to urinate a lot more frequently, be very, very thirsty, and be losing weight in an unexpected way. And so if you have those kind of symptoms, those are pretty specific for a new diagnosis of diabetes, and you should seek medical attention, I would say, whether you've had COVID or not.
All right, Dr. Brian Hollenbeck at New England Baptist. Dr. Hollenbeck, thanks for your time.